Welcome back, everybody. You know, one of the things that drives me crazy when it comes to homebrewing is taking readings just in general because there's just so many reasons. So this video is going to be a series of little tips, tricks, and hacks that I use for taking readings, and I hope it helps. So before I get started, make sure you consider looking down and hitting the subscribe button if you want to know when my next video comes out. That way you can get notified for that. So let's get started. So first things first, when you go to the homebrew store, they will sell you a hydrometer, right? Comes in these little things, and it's made of this unbelievably fragile glass. And then they'll also sell you this, a hydrometer or a graduated cylinder. First things first, this is my first beef, if you will. This sucker, first of all, I don't know if you can tell, it's made out of, I don't know if you'd call it plastic. It's the most cheapest, brittle plastic or acrylic that you can even imagine. If this were to fall, it would shatter. I mean, not quite like glass, but I mean, it would break. That's the first thing I don't like about what they're selling you. They're buying the cheapest thing possible. Secondly, you probably can't read it, but it's a 240 milliliter graduated cylinder. And honestly, I can't even touch the bottom. I'm holding this by the tip. There. I almost have to drop the hydrometer into it. It's so deep. That's too much. You don't need to use that much of a sample of your beer. It's just ridiculous that they sell you this enormous cylinder to take a reading. So the first tip I'm gonna give you is get rid of it. Don't buy this. If it comes separately, don't buy one of these giant, you know, 200 or 240 milliliter graduated cylinders. All right, waste of money. So instead, get yourself this. You can get this on Amazon. If I can remember to do it, I'll put a link in the description. This is a 100 milliliter, so it's basically half the size, or in this case, even less than that. And now I can put my hydrometer. It even sticks up a little bit, right? You really only need a 100 milliliter cylinder in order to get a reading, right? I don't know. What do you think you need? 70 milliliters, maybe 80 milliliters. I don't know if you need the full 100 milliliters of liquid. It'll go up to 100 milliliters plus a little headroom, but we'll find out in a minute. One thing I don't like about this is, especially over time, the plastic does start to get foggy, and so it gets harder and harder to read through it and see the readings on the hydrometer because it gets foggy. So, I mean, I guess you could buy a new one after a period of time. The other option, of course, is... I'm gonna leave that there because I'm gonna use it. I did bring it. I thought I brought it out. This guy. This is a glass hydrometer. Same, it's 100 milliliters. So it's the same size, only it's glass. And so it's very easy to see through. I like it a lot. Only thing is sometimes they're not super stable. Like this one, it's not exactly level. It's sort of wobbly bobbly. So you gotta kind of be careful. And of course, if this were to fall, it's gonna break, right? So, but I do like it for clarity. So one of those two items will be their first trick is you can use far less product to get your reading. And so you're not going to end up dumping out, you know, a whole bunch of beer. Now I have seen some people take the container that these things come in. I'm assuming it would have to be this side because there's like little perforations on this one. But I have seen people take like this container, fill it with their sample, then put the hydrometer in it and take a reading like this in here. I've never tried it, but I have seen people do it. Next little hack, all right? You'll see I have a little sample of beer here. Well, let's just pretend it's like boiling hot wort, okay? Either way, whether it's just your final sample or your initial sample, whatever, you can buy these syringes on Amazon. They come in like 3 or 5 packs. This is a 100 milliliter, which is the same size as our replacement, right? Smaller graduated cylinder. So normally what I would do, I'm not going to do it this time, but I would normally spray some Star Sand on here. That way it slides. Actually, I may have to go do that. Here, we'll do a little wart. Yeah, how about that? But it just makes it slide more easily. If it's not wet a little bit, it's gonna have a hard time with a plunger. These are so much better than the turkey baster. If you're still using a turkey baster, I'm telling you, get a syringe. It won't drip. The turkey basters drip everywhere. These will still drip, but not as bad. So you put it into your hot wort that's in the kettle, just the tip. If you're just doing beer, and this one I did break the little handle thingy on it, so it's a little harder for me to grab, but I still am using it. I still have like I said, it comes with two or three other ones. I want to get a full 100 milliliters because I want to see while you're on here with me. All right, that's pretty much 100 milliliters. So here's my graduated cylinder. Let's see how much I need, right? For it to start floating. It's just a lot easier to do it this way than to use the turkey baster. Oh, give me a second. It's foamed up because it's a finished beer. It's not quite floating, so it needs just a little bit more. But use far less product, and it just makes things easier. So this brings me to the final tip. When you're using boiling hot wort, you still have to cool your wort down. You can't take a reading with boiling hot wort. Even with the correction, if you put this hydrometer into boiling hot wort, you're probably gonna shatter it right into your beer, your wort, and it's gonna ruin your batch. So, what do you do? So, the thing is, if you have 100 milliliters of hot boiling wort and you need to cool it down, it takes a long time. It seems to take a long time. I mean, yeah, you could put it in an ice bath or something, but here's what I do, and this is like my ultimate hack, okay? Because nobody wants to wait forever for that, and you just really need it to get it down to like 80 degrees, because you can use a temperature correction line if you want to. Get yourself a pie tin. I think this is, is it 8-inch pie tin? You can get the disposable ones, it doesn't matter. So you take that's the amount of liquid, right, that it was floating in. So you pour that into your pie tin, and I realize you can't see probably right into it, but it's very thinly covered on the bottom. So you've got your boiling hot wort, just a very thin layer of it now. Throw that in the freezer for 5 minutes. It'll be at a readable temperature. So that's how you can take a temperature of boiling hot wort pretty quickly, spread it out like in a pie tin like this, throw it in the freezer for 5 minutes, boom, you're set. That's pretty much everything I wanted to cover today. I thought there was something else in my mind that I was gonna say about this, but I think that's it. I hope that helps because I know that it's so frustrating to try to get a sample of boiling wort or a pre-boil sample, and you want that reading really quick. The only other option really is to use a like an electronic hydrometer, like an Easy Dens, but those things are like $400, man. They're great because they only use like 10 milliliters of sample instead of like 100 in this case. And those take hardly, those cool down instantly, but that's $400. So, if you're really into the hobby and it might be worth your money if you have a little extra money to get one of those. But otherwise, this is pretty good. This is a pretty good hack. It only takes like 5 minutes to cool down this much wort till you can get an accurate temperature accurate reading. Anyway, I hope that helps. I'll be back here in a week for another full video. And until then, thanks for stopping by and go brew a beer, guys. Keep on brewing.